Hello students, good morning to all of you. Once again, I welcome you all on this online teaching platform of Divine Public School, Mohnapur, Gorakhpur. Dear students, today I am going to explain you a very important poem from your textbook Flamingo of class 12. The name of the poem is Aunt Jennifer's Tigers. This poem is written by Edwin Ridge. Your subject, as you know, it's English code. The code is 301. From the board CBSC. Now before I start explaining the poem stanza wise, I would like to give you a brief description of the poet Edwin Ridge, who has written this poem on Jennifer's Tigers. Edwin Ridge was born in 1929 in Baltimore, which is in Maryland. She is widely known for her involvement in contemporary women's movement as a poet and theorist. A strong resistance to racism and militarism echoes through her work. She is one of the most widely read and influenced poets of the second half of the 20th century. Dear student, in this poem, she talks about a woman's experiences in her married life. The poetess has also tried to explore the inner feelings of a woman who is living under the dominance of men. Now coming to this slide, specific objectives of the poem. Now through this poem, the students will learn to appreciate poetry. The specific objective of this poem is to prepare the students for the poetic forms like epics, halku, sonnet, couplet, and many more are there, and adapt them with the figure of speech, rhyme, and rhythm. So these two are the specific objectives of the poem. Now let me give you some introduction of the poem. The poem on Jennifer's Tigers addresses the constraints of married life a woman experiences. Aunt Jennifer makes prancing, sleek, chivalric tigers in the pen, but she is in the grip of ordeals and terrors. These crushed her and affected her married life. It is ironical that such a lady who has not yet freed herself from the bitter experiences of the past creates such sleek and prancing tigers. These tigers will go on prancing round and unafraid even after her death. Now in this poem, the poetess represents the kind of women who were caught under the oppressive hand of a patriarchal society. Now dear student, let me explain you what is patriarchal society. Patriarchal society is a system of society or government controlled by men. The poetess Edwin Ridge, through the simple lines of the poem, delineates a woman's struggle with expression and rebellion. The three quatrains, that means the four-lined stanza, expose the desolating effects of patriarchy. Now coming to the explanation of stanza 1. Before I start explaining, I would like to read the stanza for you all. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across a screen, bright topaz denizens of a world of green. They do not fear the men beneath the tree. They pace in sleek, chivalric certainty. Now, dear students, in this stanza, the very first stanza, the poet first introduces us to Aunt Jennifer's dreams. Now, as you can see the image of the tiger, dear students, are you scared after listening or hearing or seeing this wild and ferocious animal, the name tiger? Yes, but students, I am not scared. Some of you may be thinking that as the title of the poem is Aunt Jennifer's Tiger, so these tigers are the pet of Aunt Jennifer. That is why sir is not scared, but it's not like that. Now, how many students have seen the tiger? Have you ever seen tiger in real? Yes. Some of the students might have seen the tiger in the zoo. Some of the students on the Discovery Channel. They are very wild and ferocious animal. But here, what does the tigers represents is all about. That means this poem is all about the tigers. Why Aunt Jennifer's Tigers is the title of the poem. Before I start explaining, let's have a look. The difficult words of this stanza. Look at the first line and the first word, that is prance. The meaning of the difficult word prance is jump over. Now the second difficult word is screen, that means a wall, or you can say here a piece of cloth. Then comes the third difficult word, that is topaz. Topaz is a transparent yellow stone used in jewelry. Then fourth one is denizens, which means dwellers, where you inhabit. That means this animal's tiger inhabits. Then comes beneath. The meaning of the difficult word beneath is under. Then comes sleek. The meaning of the word sleek is shining and well-groomed. And the last, that is the seventh difficult word in this stanza, is chivalric. That means honorable and brave. Is it clear, students? Now, see the first line. First line of the stanza. As just now I have said, that in this very first stanza, the poet first introduces us to Aunt Jennifer's dreams. Now, Aunt Jennifer's tiger prance across a screen. Now, the poet here in this very first stanza is describing a lady whom she addresses as Aunt Jennifer. Poetess says that Aunt Jennifer is doing embroidery on a piece of cloth, which could be a tablecloth or a wall hanging. She has designed it with beautiful tigers which are prancing. Dear students, you might have seen the logo of Puma. There you can see, that means if you see the logo, if you have seen the logo, you can see a tiger jumping over. That means in the mode of jumping. So she, that means the Aunt Jennifer, has designed it with beautiful tigers which are running fearlessly in the green forest. Now see the second line. Bright topaz denizens of a world of green. Poetess has described their beauty by comparing them with a precious yellow stone known as topaz. Dear students, the meaning of topaz is a transparent yellow stone used in jewelry. You might have seen that it is a kind of precious stone which people used to wear, or they put in the gold ring and they wear in their fingers. Many of you may have seen that. Now here the poet is comparing the tiger, comparing this beauty with a precious yellow stone known as topaz. That means tigers, who are the denizens, that means they dwells in the green forest. If you have seen the tiger, the color of the tiger is like a stone which is known as topaz, yellow stone. The poetess says that they appear bright yellow in the green backdrop of the forest. These tigers are fearless and they are not affected by the presence of men, those who are sitting under the tree. Here we can sense the contrast of behavior between the tigers and Aunt. Though the tigers designed by her are fearless, but she herself is afraid of her husband. Further, the poet says that the tigers are proud and fearless citizens of the forest. They are very shiny and elegant. That means the tigers are very shining and well groomed and very brave. Now look at the literary devices in this stanza. The first one is the rhyme scheme, that is AABB. The second literary device, the poetic device, is use of same word in two consecutive lines. As you can see in the third line, they do not, and in the fourth line, they pace in. That means they do not fear and they pace in. Same words in two consecutive lines. The literary device here is anaphora. Then comes the metaphor. Use of topaz to describe the yellow color of tigers. That is in the second line, that is bright topaz. That means topaz is used to describe the yellow color of the tigers. Now coming to the explanation of stanza second. On Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool, find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. Now, dear student, in the second stanza, we are introduced to the reality of Aunt Jennifer's world. Now, see the difficult words in this stanza. The first one is fluttering, which means moving about. The second one is ivory, that means a needle made of ivory. Its color is yellowish white. Then comes the massive weight, which means heavy. And at last, the difficult word is wedding band, which means engagement ring, which you can see in the image. Now, dear students, here the poet describes the fear of Aunt Jennifer towards her husband. She says that while she is doing embroidery, her fingers are quivering, that means shaking, with fear of her husband. Actually, her husband doesn't approve of her hobby of embroidery. That means the husband of Aunt Jennifer dislikes the hobby of Aunt Jennifer, that is embroidery. Therefore, she trembles while she is embroidering the piece of cloth. It has become very difficult for her to pull her needle up and down. Though the needle, which is made of ivory, the elephant tusk, is very light in weight, but the hand of Aunt Jennifer finds it very difficult to pull the needle up and down. Then the poetess describes the wedding ring, which was given by uncle to Aunt Jennifer on their wedding day. She says that it is a kind of burden for her to wear this ring. Now the question arises, why? Why the ring, which is very light in weight, is a burden for Aunt Jennifer to wear? Actually, student, Aunt Jennifer has been tortured by her husband so much that the wedding ring, which could have been a beautiful gift for her, seems like a burden to her. She has faced so many difficulties in her married life that the little small ring is described as a heavy band on her trembling fingers. This means that the ring, which is light in weight, is associated with some bad experiences in the form of torture. She is not satisfied with her married life. She had faced many of the tortures because of her husband's dominating behavior. Now let's see the literary devices. The first one is rhyme scheme, same AABB. And the second poetic device is alliteration. F sound is repeated in finger fluttering. As you can see in the very first line, fingers fluttering. Is it clear, students? Now moving to the stanza 3. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie, still ringed with ordeals she was mastered by. The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. Now, dear students, in this third stanza, which is a narrative of the future. But before I explain, let's have a look at the difficult words. The first one is terrified. Terrified meaning is scared. The second difficult word is ringed, that means surrounded by. The third difficult word is ordeals, that means difficult experiences. Fourth difficult word is mastered, that means controlled by. Then comes the panel, which means board, and last prancing, which means jump over. Now coming to the explanation, let's go through the explanation of the third stanza. As it is a narrative of the future, the poet says that one can easily sense aunt's desire for freedom and fearlessness through her design of tigers. The poetess further says that it is not possible for aunt to achieve this freedom during her lifetime. She will attain it only after her death. But here also, the irony of her life is that still she will be tied up with shackles in the form of her husband's wedding ring. That means when Aunt Jennifer will die, then also in the hands of Aunt Jennifer, there will be what? The wedding ring, which was a gift for Aunt Jennifer on their marriage. The ring was the sole proof of the tortures which she had faced from her husband. On the other hand, there are the tigers designed by Aunt Jennifer, which will always depict her desire of living a fearless life by jumping proudly and bravely on the piece of cloth. That means she has depicted a design which is in contrast of her behavior. She is a simple lady, very polite lady, whereas on the other hand, the tigers are wild and ferocious. So tiger and the behavior of aunt, or you can say aunt, the nature, the behavior is totally contrast to each other. Now let's see the literary devices. The first one is rhyme scheme, that means AA, BB, and the second poetic device is alliteration. P is repeated in prancing proud, as you can see in the fourth line, that is the last line, prancing proud. Now dear student, in this slide I have given you a few questions. You have to write the answer of these questions. The question number one, how is the poem a forceful expression of the evils of patriarchy? Question number two, what ordeals do you think Aunt Jennifer is surrounded by? Question number three, why do you think Aunt Jennifer created animals contrasting her personality? Question number four, justify the title of the poem Aunt Jennifer's Tigers. Question number five, do you think Aunt Jennifer's Tigers is a tragic poem? Why not? Question number six, what is real message in the poem? Question number seven, how does the poet describe Aunt Jennifer's Tigers? Question number eight, why are Aunt Jennifer's hands terrified? So there are eight questions. You have to write the answers of this question in the classwork copy and you have to submit when the school gets reopened. Now let's see the theme of the poem. The poem revolves around desires and the depressingly harsh realities of Aunt Jennifer's existence. Using sharp contrast between the tigers and herself, that means aunt, the tigers appears to be in sharp contrast to her personality. The tigers' action are smooth, uninhibited, and robust. Aunt Jennifer, on the other hand, has great trouble even to embroider because her movements are so weak. Aunt Jennifer is evidently a lonely, pained old woman plagued by anxiety. The reason for her miserable plight is the oppressive patriarchal family system, wherein the whole soul of the family is the masculine gender, and it is he, that means the male, who dominates the scene. She creates an alternative world of freedom, a world that she desires for. Now, learning outcomes of this poem. The students will be able to empathize with Aunt Jennifer's problems and seek resolution. The second learning outcome is they will discern prevailing inequalities in various guises. There are two learning outcomes of this poem. Thank you, students, for watching and listening. Thank you very much.